Greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall as a Mage. We are continuing with the side quests, and today's order of business is to complete a few quests for the Order of Arkay, and yeah, nothing much to it. Let's go. Alright then, here's a quester. Let us go ahead and save the game here first. Where do we want to save? Yeah, pre-quest. Forgot about us. Yeah, here we are. Alright, let us get a quest from you then. Novice, one of our clerics, a man in a blue coat named Mordable Ashley, has disappeared while on an archaeological dig. Will you help him find us? Looks like we're gonna have to go digging ourselves. Sure, that's good, good. That's good, good. Now then, Mordable Ashley went to the Disporgon shrine close to a fortnight ago to conduct his dig. It's possible that all is well, but I'll give you 18 days to go there, find him, and come back. Arkay walk with you, novice. Farewell. Right, Arkay walk with me instead. So I'll just wait around here to, you know, cast the levitate spell, and then we'll figure out what to do once the time comes. I don't think I really have many provisions right now. Like, I don't really have an access to anything right now. Unlike a mage skill where I can, like, make custom spells or whatever. That should be enough loitering teleport right here. And let's cast it. I want to set the anchor here. And let us then open up the lockbook. Disporgon Shrine. Ah. Of course, I need to head out for that first. Yeah, here we go. I'm just ensuring that I have everything. Yeah, this could be put inside the wagon. Do I want to wear this, I wonder? Cast and health, fortitude. Can I like equip this stuff? Of course I can't. And vest of the Orc Lord. Should I wear this just to get like a strength boost? Maybe. Yeah, for now I'll just keep this in the wagon as well. And yeah, maybe we'll go ahead and just equip this to this. Can't hurt, right? I mean, up until the point that we can begin enchanting things ourselves, might as well rely on already enchanted items. That's a downright hole. Let's go ahead and save an attention slot. Yeah, the frames have returned. Let us go then. At least I can rest here, even though I can like hear some monster nearby, but yeah. Oh, right. Yeah, I was wondering why I got like this charm of sorts, but that's probably because of... Let me go ahead and save you, because I could rest right here. Right. So, to begin with... Okay, there are skeletons here. And he's dead. Pretty good actually, I mean, the fact that the skeleton died so easily. I was expecting it to be a far tougher battle, but apparently it was not. So let's put down a bead right here to denote the fact that we are going to explore that side later. Now this is actually the first time I'm hearing this soundtrack. I don't think I've ever heard it before. A harpy. Hi. You know what? Let me just bypass you, since I clearly can't hit you. How about Aloha Mora? I hear a skeleton, but I think it's not near me. For now, at least. Alright. Okay, now this soundtrack is appearing really. Huh. That guy hit me with like a fireball and did zero damage, but it actually gave me mana, so I'm sort of grateful for that actually. Alright, so let us go ahead and check out the right first. Then we can go ahead and check out the rest of the dungeon. Saving here, because you never know when the game's gonna crash. Although it doesn't really typically occur this early on, but you never know. Anything here? Nothing really. I keep hearing something like a werewolf or a werebore, I don't know what that is, but yeah, definitely keep hearing something. Let us, let us go ahead and take that out. Take that bead out, I mean. No hidden tools or anything here. This I don't think is anything worth grabbing. Problem is, you never know with these things. You never know. I'm liking the soundtrack, by the way. I don't think I've heard it before, but I am liking it. This is one of those rooms. Nothing here. I don't know whether somebody opened a door or whether that was like Hi. Hi. That was monk, steel battle axe, buckler, iron mace, and leather stuff that I don't really require, to be honest. Might as well. I mean, we do have free XP, to be honest. Or should we just rest here? Until later. Before I go ahead and rest, let me just, can I not, like... Yeah. I will have to unequip this to unequip my vest, to be honest. Or maybe I can just go ahead and, you know, equip this. That'll take care of that. And let's rest here. Okay, saving again. Saved. Now, let us go ahead and... I was wondering why I'm hitting so hard, and that's probably because of this. The Orc, the vest of the Orc Lord. How much does that give me? 73 strength? That is a significant boost, I feel like. Aqueous form, right here. Water breathing and water walking combined. True. It has probably been added to the bestiary. Yes, it has. Ooh, where did this come out? There was actually a door back there. Let's just quickly go ahead and check it out before I proceed ahead. I think it should be somewhere around... nah, it's actually near the entrance there. Right here. Who would have thought that there would be a door here, of all places? Iron longsword, religious item, and a scarab. Anything else? Why is everything in this room upside down, is the question. Interesting. Maybe they're just light. These things make a ton of noise, but then again, everything underwater should make very loud and deep noises just like that. Propagation of sounds is different underwater than it is above water, so it sort of makes sense for it to do that. Hi there! That was a healer, I've got ectoplasm, lots of alchemical ingredients, restore power, let's go! In case I ever need to use it. Saving again. And her aqueous form is wearing off just in time. That's an imp. Hi there. You really thought you could hit me with that spell, huh? And do like any amount of damage. Anyway, saving again. You should actually not be saving as often. Hold up. Before I go ahead, I want to just place a bead down there to denote it as a point in time that we should probably explore further later when we have the time. I see you, Skeletal Warrior. Why don't you come on in? Come on. Why don't you guys get caught up in like a fight of sorts, huh? Or I could just go ahead and, you know, do that. Okay, let's go ahead and re-update the save here. So if you're going to save often, might as well save on the same save slot as much as possible. I don't think my heartbeat is leveling up just because I'm walking in front of these characters. Typically that is not how that works. You actually have to talk to them for it to work, and unless and until... Hold up. Oh, I see. That's where we come out. Interesting. I'll just go ahead and drop a bead right there. And remove this one, because we have already covered that side. Well, there's nothing here. Recasting invisibility, because why not? And since we are coming here, might as well destroy the speed. Imp! Impish fashion. I wonder why these guys typically have talismans and stuff. I healed myself just to keep my restoration up. Nothing else around the corners really, so which way do we want to go first? Let us drop a bead on both sides. And opt to continue forward. Ah, of course. Now, here's the thing, this is level 6 lock. Even if I manage to successfully cast this spell, I will not be able to open it because it is level 6 lock. Leather gauntlets. Black rose. Potion of levitation and a holy candle. Oh, I see. I hear other objectionable stuff around. Just wasn't expecting that thing to pop, you know, up behind me. Ah, I see. That's one way to take care of them, I suppose. Since we are headed that way. There isn't a hidden door there, is there? No, I suppose not. Since we are going this way, let us remove this bead right here and head forward. First, save. Another one, I see. You guys have like a ton of alchemical ingredients for me to obtain from you. It's a real pity, I actually really liked the Leech Vitality spell that I had created, but unfortunately the spell is really expensive. Here we go, up the steps. I'm just clicking on every torch I come across because you never know which... I hear a skeleton there. So for now I'm just gonna drop a bead right here. It's probably gonna come out anytime soon. Well, it doesn't, let me just go ahead and explore this room. Nothing here from the looks of it. Nothing on the walls. I love the world tooltips dialogue. Come on. Why are you shying away? I also like fireball because I get to absorb all of the mana that I'm depleting. Let me go ahead and rest here. Until fully healed, of course. Probably should have taken the shirt off first, but oh well, let's resave. So anything here that remains yet unexplored? I think not. I think we have explored this part of the dungeon quite well enough. So let us head back downstairs and get to that portion that we had previously left unexplored. Alright. Now this part of the dungeon seems pretty small, which makes me think that this actually might be a... Let's just go there and deposit the stuff that we got back into the... Yeah. Oh, it's raining outside. How nice. What did we get? Right. This, and yeah, let's keep that. I don't really know what it does, because it's supposedly supposed to cast fortitude when held, but I don't really know how to hold it. I can't equip it, I can't use it, so anyway. Let's remove all of this stuff into... Whoops, not that. I feel like I might have removed a few too many things from my inventory there. Yes. I think that's good enough. And ingredients, let us put all this into the cart, because we have got no use for it right now. We are not a field alchemist yet, even though we might soon be one. For the time being, we are not. So no point in bothering with it. There wasn't a... Yeah, there was no hidden door here. Hi. You're dead. But you did give me 15 gold pieces, so that's good on you. And now that we're here, let us remove the bead. So yeah, since the dungeon seems so small, from whatever I've explored of it, I feel like it could of course be like a minor dungeon, but it could also be a teleport dungeon, you never know. So let's save here. Yep, and the rest of the dungeon is slowly opening up. We'll have to bash this door in. Actually, let us go ahead and cast it nonetheless, because it is going to help us level up, regardless of whether or not we are able to open this door. I heard a harpy, but I can't locate it right now. Nothing here. Ah, there you are. I see. So I'm guessing I'm either looking for a man or some sort of a severed finger or something, because that's just the nature of these things. Why do I hear water near me? Probably another underwater section, but I'm actually not that... Do you guys make that noise? Interesting. I did not think you guys would be the kind of people to make that sort of noise. One there, because we're heading straight. And let's put another one there. Okay, somebody has detected us. I don't know who it is. Question is, how did the skeleton not detect us? He's dead. Somebody was tossing some kind of a spell at us, and most likely it was an imp, but I have no idea where he was doing that from. The imp, I mean. Alright, let's rest here. Our invisibility is about to run out anyway. Maybe save slot too. Alright, let us go ahead and remove this bead. Because we are about to explode this side now. Right. The plot thickens. Hi. Why do you guys even try? I mean, why? You guys got a bruise? Or is it just a side effect of you guys attacking that's doing it? I feel like it's the latter, because typically these guys are not able to open doors, and typically these sections that we have here don't really have quest objectives either. They're like these transition sections in between. I keep hearing something. Oh, that's a skeleton. Hi. Steel flail, iron flail helm, leather cuirass, right. We'll address that skeleton later. For now, I'll just put a bead right here, and let's head downstairs. I feel like this is gonna probably make a circle back to somewhere we've already been. Oh, I see. That's what was going on there. Holy water, prayer beads, potion of resist shock, sure. Anything to make things cheaper for me. Basilisk's eye. These guys typically don't have a lot of... How do I put this? Gold on them. Not that I'm doing whatever I'm doing just for the gold, but yeah. There's another one of you guys in there. I'm getting lots of stuff here. The only reason I'm using magic is to level up my destruction, because these guys can be slain with just one hit of my saber, to be honest. Okay, yeah, we have come like full circle, I do believe. Yeah, so maybe we can just safely discard this, take a left here. Left, was it? Or was it a right? I do believe it was left. Now, have we left? Yes, we have left this one section unexplored up there. So let's go ahead and explore that then. Let's heal. Create some magicka for health. I love how smooth this game becomes with, you know, the Unity mod. Some people like to call it like an altogether different game. And, well, I don't really see myself disagreeing with them. I can hear skellies being the reason I... Okay, this it's this module, essentially. Why is she so aggro right now? Actually, let me just go old school on her. No, it was a healer. Rainwater. Lots of stuff here. Let me go ahead and save because I haven't saved in a while. I have a bad feeling about what's about to happen next. Let me keep putting down beads here and there, just to denote which areas I'm yet to cover. I was wondering, this dungeon seems a little straightforward. Just a teeny bit straightforward, you know? Oh, there you are. I was wondering where you might be. There probably are more there, as should be the case. This should open up into like a pyramid sort of structure in the end of it all. Yep, right here we go. Typically, you might find the quest objective standing right here. Might. Not always, but you might. Hi. You got lots of hit points, don't you? Alright, now there are other, like, lots of... How do I put this? Places around here where we can practically get extra loot. But I'm not particularly interested in getting any of them right now. And what the hell is that? That better not be a lich down there. Although I feel like if it was, it probably would have hit me already. No, that's just a battle mage. Alright. This is like Ambush Central, this entire structure. Oh shit. At least we're underwater. And no, don't worry, nothing here can get you. Let us go ahead and cast boat so that we can float our way back out of here. So that place is the only module with the quest objective being there. Like the quest, that's the only place where the quest objective can be. Not inside the pyramid. Especially considering that it's underwater. So I was thinking the dungeon seems pretty straightforward. Has to be more to it. Well, guess what? There is. Alright, so this side has officially been explored, so let me just remove this bead. And let's keep heading forward then. There's also the skull here, but it does not have an interact prompt on it, meaning that it's probably not an interactable skull there. Ox blood, pine branch. Should I save you? Let's go and save. This one? Sure. Probably should have saved on a different slot, but oh well. It's fine. That's how you do it, son. I see. So, all my spells were colliding with these boots. And that was into saving that poor little guy from dying. So let's close this road back up, because we'll be exploring this side first. Low effort dungeon crawls, you don't even need to walk. You can literally just float away. Yeah, let's check out the auxiliary path first. That is another imp there. I'll get back to you. Hi. Lots of places to explore here. Oh yeah, so the quest objective can actually be in one of the little alleyways near the pyramid. So let us go ahead and explore this first. Oh, there's a map. A freshly drawn map indicates the long-lost location of the graves of Moorfield, which you copy down. Let us go ahead and save. Because we could definitely use a save right now. And let us rest here on the ground for a bit. Until fully healed, of course. And we'll save in slot 1. Good thing is I'm using like the save function a lot. Let's destroy the speed since we have already been there. If I'm correct, and I hope I'm correct, I think this is the way that'll take us into the edges of that pyramid down there. Probably should have explored this area while we had the chance. I'll not save I'll save my spell points. I'll not try anymore. Like, if they're consistently getting saves, better to like save your spell points. Ah, here you go. Hi. What else do you have? There's a bomb? What is a bomb? I've got no idea. Yeah, so if you touch that chain, I think it casts slow falling on you, so that you don't really fall as fast. I'll just go ahead and run a perimeter around this place. Cool! Potion recipe. I have no idea what for, but yeah, you can pretty much just craft your own potions in this game. Using these potion recipes, of course, you can't just do it haphazardly. Okay, so there are, we have already covered that route. So there are like three doors right here that we can choose from. Let's start off with the one on the left. You never know where these doors are going to take you, to be honest. These randomly take you somewhere. Yeah, this is going to cause slowfall, which is going to eat us down there. Although, whether that is advisable or not, I have no idea. I just want to quickly check out whether... No, that's still just a human. Nobody for us to actually go ahead and meet. So yeah, let's go through the store. Before that, let us go ahead and save. Alright, here we go. Just a human enemy. But these guys typically have like good loot, being the reason why I want to. You, my dear, have been poisoned. I forgot what effects it has, the poison spell that I had created. I'm just doing it to level up destruction. That's it. I can hear some water lapping around. Now, this I will keep for later. For now, I want to check this side out because typically this might be the one with, you know, the quest objective behind it. Sometimes it can be there. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. You never really know what to expect. And these are also... Oh, there's a door there. I see. Hi there. Yeah, you guys fight it out. I'll just bear witness to your extraordinary battle. And... I could hear him under the skelly in there, being the reason why I was a little hesitant about coming out here in the first place. But yeah, like I was saying, these things can also have the quest objectives behind them nestled away. I see. Ooh, this looks royal. And is that... Yeah, that is like a little box there. A tiny little box. Okay, so... Like, sometimes these square banners, especially if they're on the ground, they're not actually banners, they're doors. I feel like I haven't used Glacial Aura in a while. Oh, I see. I see what's going on there. Fuck you. Yeah, fuck you too. I'm amazed to see how well I'm holding up against these guys. I did not expect myself to hold up against them that well. Good to see that I can still use the arrow controls from, you know. Excuse me? You did not just... Did you just guesstimate my location and bonk me? I love fighting enemies who don't know where I am. I could definitely could use that. There's a tower shield as well, but not that we really need it. I'm gonna cast locks again, and let's just head all the way back in here, close this door, and rest right in the middle of this place right here. and I'll take the safe. To be fair on ourselves, we did, in fact, battle a lot of creatures. So, I would suppose a save is in order. Wait, is there like a hidden, another hidden door there? Somewhere? Because I heard somebody take a swing at me. Let's check out the left first, we'll check out the right later. Oh fuck you. If you have like a good tempo, then you can actually recharge yourself. Like recharge your own spell points. There's a dead imp in there. Good job. Good job, Harpy. Good job. Good going indeed. Lock has nothing to fear from me. Maybe a lower motor. Let's try that. Maybe once again. Of course, the effect failed. Nothing here. I wonder why these. We'll keep the path on the right for later. Let's just go ahead and explore this side first. Like, go upstairs, as in. Okay, and here we are. With no clue where we're coming out of. Okay, just a resting room, nothing fancy. Dungeon crawls. I'm actually trying to pace myself with this game. I don't really want to like burn myself out playing it. That's also one of the reasons why is this thing floating in midair like that. Anyway, that's one of the reasons why you guys don't see me. Ah, there's a hidden door there. I was wondering. That was an easily open door. I see. We essentially come out there. You know what, let's just leave the bead lying down there and let's head back. I can hear a skeleton somewhere over there. I don't know where it is. I can just hear it going all over the place. I wonder if skeletons even do that, considering the fact that they do not have anything resembling a voice box. I do believe this was the way that we had to head. Yes, indeed. I want to clear the side out first because it might just have what we're looking for. If the trends follow suit. The trends that I've observed thus far, I mean. Oh hey, there's like a letter of sorts here, but not one that we can pick up. I do believe I've seen this module in castles, but this is like just dungeon decoration, nothing more, because we cannot interact with that. We cannot pick it up. I hear a skelly and an imp. Okay, here we go. A part with an elevator with a gate. First to check out. So the question now is, who the hell? Ah, it is you. I see. I was asking who the hell was it that decided to hit me with a damn fireball while I was still fighting the skeleton. Turns out it was the imp. Feels like we have been here before.
Yep.
We just came out of this maze through another side. Now again, yet again, I would like to keep this place unexplored and explore it later. I quickly want to clear out the part downstairs first. And then of course this is the matter of this gate right here, which I have no idea how to open up yet. Pretty sure that the answer to that will reveal itself as time progresses. For now, yeah. This dungeon has nice modules, I'll say that much. This dungeon has pretty nice modules. I healed because I had free magicka. I had magicka to spare, essentially. To be honest, considering the fact that I... Okay, somebody's coming out to get me. And here's to hoping... Oh, there's an Iron Maiden there. Considering the fact that there's like a harpy there, I hope that they get embroiled in their own little battles. You're durable, aren't you? Iron katana and a silver longsword. I'm leaving the harpies alone because they're sentient creatures. I mean, technically so are humans, but... Yeah, double sciences, you know. Alright, let us go ahead and explore this side then. Let's see where this takes us. You feel a rift of energy. I wonder what that means. A rift of energy, you say? Interesting. Well, these guys do have a lot of loot as well, so that makes them like prime targets, juicy targets. Aloha Mora. Of course, the spell effect field. Because why would it not? Now, where the hell did we come out? Okay, so we have officially explored that side of the dungeon then. Let's remove this bead, because that was going to be our next stop anyway. And I do believe we have completely explored those tunnels down there. I do not see any enemies there. Considering the fact that we have not found... Wait a minute. There's also this side that we have yet to explore. So I'll just leave that lying there. And leave this here. And go explore the other side. But first, let me just bash this door open. Come on. It does not unlock. Why would it? I wish these were lootable, but apparently they're not. Oh hey, the gate on this side is open. That's interesting. Like, we have seemingly explored those areas as well. Unwittingly, most likely, but we have explored those areas. Yeah, I'm just keeping those in place so that I know to keep exploring them, essentially. Or so I believe. But they have seemingly been explored. To completion. At that. Because that area, that side is a dead end, there's nothing there. Except for that gate over there. I wonder how to open that gate. I wonder if we have to dive into the pyramid just to open that gate. And if the quest objective is truly behind it. It might be, you never know. I don't know whether to call that the beauty of Daggerfall, but yeah, that's how it is with Daggerfall. Alright, so we have actually been down there as well. It's just the other side of the gate. The longer way around. So I guess we don't really need to particularly check that door out. Elven shot bow. Let's cast some healing and save and move on. Let's save here. I feel like I've been slacking off on the saving part. I can hear a harpy. Ah, there you are, of course. Mordival Ashley, why are you so short? I really did not expect you to be this short, son. You're extremely short. I literally have to come down to your level like this. Then you look slightly tall, in fact, but my god. Thank Arkay, you came. I've been searching for the way out for close to a week. I'll follow you back to the temple. Well, you don't really need to do that because I'll be teleporting out of here. Here we go! After much practice, you feel ready to advance further in mysticism. Good, good, good. That's exactly what I like to hear. So, let us hand this quest in then. Here you go, the quest objective. A whole tiny little human that can fit right into my knapsack. Ah, novice and good module, Ashley. It is good to have you back in the Order of Arkay again. I had feared the worst, to be honest. It would have been the worst if you had not sent me. You should be thanking me. This bug is apparently caused by, according to one of the commenters, I actually don't remember the names of you guys, when it comes to actually, quoting you guys, but the person has a profile picture of a cat, essentially. And they commented that this apparently occurs because of a mod which enables me to see through these windows, transparent windows or whatever they are called. What the fuck just happened? Shit. I got super scared there for a second. Anyhow. Frames, please come back, thank you. She went bonkers there for a second. Heilfuhrer. Anyway, let's go ahead and talk to him then. Congratulations, Strangebird. For all your efforts toward the greater glory of Arkay, we have raised you to the rank of Initiate. With this change in title, you are also gaining access to our cauldron, where our chemists devise potions for our temple. You need no longer travel to the Mage's Guild in order to purchase necessary potions. The Mage's Guild don't offer potions anyway. Seriously. Huh. So I guess that's what I came here for, to get promoted to Initiate. And Teachers of Arkay, Perrine Vicard, Temple Treasurers, Temple Healers. Where's the Potion Master? Apothecaries. Oh yeah, that's the Daedra Summoner. Those dudes look gnarly. They don't look nice. Yeah, let's buy some potions from them. Poison Bridge Shock, Shadow Form, Restore Power, Healing. Now it looks like I got both the potions of. How about this? Restore Power, and let's get some potions of healing as well, just in case. Free Action, don't really think I would need that, but you never know. Resist Poison, yes. I essentially want any potion that'll cure me, so to speak. So, yeah, let's go ahead and. Let us buy all that, 480 gold. Yeah, and let's transfer some things over into the wagon. Mostly the alchemical ingredients. And yeah, let's go ahead and equip this to preserve. How do I put this? Potion of healing, potion of reaction. And Potion of Restore Power, got 3 now. That's amazing. Letter of Credit and Letter from the Princess of Vedas. Time to put this into... Wait, I cannot? Why cannot I remove this item then? I have already done that, right? Yeah. I should be able to remove that item. Anyhow, I'll not press it. Elven Short Bow. Fine. What I've been fearing finally happened. You should really not be standing out there in the rain at the dead of night like that, even though you are right next to a temple. And I really do feel guilty for teleporting you alongside me. At least right here I will not be molested by thieves because I'm invisible. So yeah, we can safely keep this inside. So the thing that I had been fearing actually happened and my game crashed, so I essentially, luckily though, I had been saving often enough to where I just had to grab the guy, teleport back and hand him over again. And I actually could not buy the same amount of potions for whatever reason. Daggerfall Unity did not actually, the persistent loot did not kick in by the time I had finished buying my potions from them yet. So yeah, right now we're literally just in the dead of the night here, but this is it for this video. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be picking up from here, and we will essentially be traveling to Menevia, to the Mage's Guild in Menevia, to complete quests for them, instead of sticking to Illicent Hills. I want to keep Illicent Hills as just a... Ooh, this looks so gorgeous. It's just a place where I have to travel to, essentially. You look like a quester, quest giver. where I have to travel to, you also do. You look like Lady Brisiana Magnuson. Anybody ever told you that? Anyhow, you probably have no idea who I'm talking about, do you? Yeah, food and drinks. Let's get like some meat for a job well done. And let us get a room. Rooms are still expensive for me for whatever reason. So anyhow, yeah, and the next time we come back, we'll be traveling over to Menevia to complete a... Let's leave for sex house. Right, so complete a quest for the Mage Guild. Now the reason I'm actually traveling to Menevia is so that I can discover, well, the location of a quest dungeon that would be beneficial for us later. Dreams, yeah. So the location of this quest dungeon that I'm talking about, and this quest dungeon is only revealed to us after, you know, completing certain quests for a certain faction of Daggerfall. But I, for one, do not. Yeah, so like I was saying, I for one do not. Why is my mana back at full? Anyhow, yeah. Wait, did I not? Okay, ready later today. Fine, fine, fine. I'm basically making collection of dwarven staffs. So like, basically a collection of staffs is what I'm doing. So I'm basically ordering all sorts of staffs that I can see. Can I not? Yeah, for example, like I already have an iron staff, a steel staff, a silver staff, an elven staff. Now I already have an ebony staff, and they actually look really pretty. Like for example, this iron staff, that's what they look like in your hands as well. And then there's, of course, that's the ebony staff, that's the steel staff. You can like actually tell how they look sort of different from each other. Then there's the silver staff, which looks just marginally better, but in your hands it looks different, like that. And then of course there's the elven staff, which looks quite groovy actually, like complete with this entire thing right here. That's what it looks like, for the record. And yeah, so that's what I'm doing. So that's why I've ordered like a dwarven staff for myself. That's new, that's almost new. Let's keep this back in the wagon. Let's unequip that and keep that back in the wagon. Yeah, let's just go ahead and equip this one, because that is our staff. So yeah, the next time we come back, I will be traveling to Menevia to complete quests for the Mage Guild there. Now the reason that I'm actually doing it in Menevia is because it unlocks a dungeon for us. It tells us the location of a dungeon which is essential to the main questline. Now the standard or traditional way to do it is you essentially wait around until you essentially complete some quests for a certain somebody in Sentinel, and they will... I did not want to do that now. Yeah, pick up order. Dwarven staff right here. That looks really fancy. Let's see here. Ooh, that looks really fancy. But yeah, so typically, the typical way to complete that task is you essentially complete a quest for, you know, Sentinel, and that will give you the location of that certain dungeon. But since I will not be aligning myself with Sentinel at all, I will not be completing even, how do I put this? What's his name? That prince. The Prince of Sentinel who sends us to look for his lost brother. So I'll not be completing that quest as well. Since we're in the Mage's Guild, we will hopefully eventually be getting a quest which will take us to Dereni Tower eventually. So yeah. So with that being said, for those of you who have played this game, I'm talking about the tomb, and yeah, I essentially want to make sure that 2 days, 624 gold, sure. Right. So, oh yeah, I also want to sell you some stuff. It's in the wagon. Actually, no, I want to keep that. all that, the rest is for me. I don't really want to sell any of that. Right, cool. You have strange sheep. Yeah. So yeah, the next time we come back, or even rather henceforth, not just the next time we come back, henceforth all Mage's Guild quests will be done in Menevia, and I will essentially be leaving it up to RNG to disclose the location of the tomb to us. So yeah, why is it lagging now of all times? Yeah, that was like a stutter. That wasn't even lag, that was a proper stutter right there. Anyhow, so yeah, so essentially all further Mage Guild quests will be done in Menevia. And with that being said, that is where I leave you guys today. So thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Until next time, when we see each other in Menevia. In the Mage Guild, of course. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Oathlings.